So you've been trying to feel good, to get some pleasure in life, but despite your efforts, you just can't seem to feel happy. And how is it that you're stuck doing the same behaviors you promised yourself you would quit? What's going on? Is there something wrong with you? No, there isn't. You're simply doing what people say you should. And that constantly puts you in the same frustrating place. But once you understand the paradox of pleasure, once you learn how to manage and leverage your dopamine system, you will finally be able to break that cycle. Let me start with a short story. When I was younger, I discovered a particular niche in video games, and I got hooked. The first time I played, I felt incredible. My dopamine level spiked, so I obviously wanted to continue and prolong these feelings. But after hours of playing, that feeling was gone, and I felt like things in real life were somewhat irrelevant, annoying, and frustrating. It got better. But I couldn't stop thinking about going back and feeling great again. So naturally, I played again, and it felt great as I had hoped. Just a bit less great than the first time, and a bit worse after I finished. This downward trend continued until I felt terrible when not playing. The world outside became gray, boring, and pointless. As Dr. Huberman wisely said, addiction is a progressive narrowing of things that bring you pleasure. That was exactly how I felt. External world, real things, simply felt irrelevant, just meh. But even that wasn't the end of the process. As I continue on that path, even playing, my drug of choice, couldn't bring me pleasure. It just made me feel less miserable. All of that was because of how our motivation and reward systems work. Psychiatrist Dr. Anna Lemke from Stanford, the author of a great book Dopamine Nation, describe it as a pleasure-pain seesaw. So how does this work? Our bodies try to maintain their natural homeostasis, countering significant deviations from its internal state. The more aggressively you seek pleasure, the more your system tilts towards pain. With time and repeated exposure, you develop tolerance to pleasure through downregulation of your dopamine receptors. Your system also starts tilting towards pain, with heightened susceptibility to pain signals. As Dr. Anna Lemke said, the pursuit of pleasure for its own sake ultimately leads to anhedonia, or the absence of pleasure in anything we do. Relentless pursuit of pleasure actually makes us miserable, and that is the paradox of pleasure seeking. Wait, so are we supposed to avoid pleasure in our lives? I mean, what's the point? Nobody wants that. No, of course not. You have to understand, our brains evolved thousands of years ago on savanna in times of scarcity. Our motivation and reward system with pleasure seeking were very well balanced for such an environment. Unfortunately, now we live in a very different, modern, technological world of abundance. That change happened too fast for our evolution and our adaptation to catch up. So we are stuck with a motivation system that cannot handle this abundance. Not only that, but we are constantly surrounded by supernormal stimuli. Yes, a fancy name, but very important. So what are these supernormal stimuli? Animals, including humans, evolved to pay attention to certain characteristics or stimuli that were advantageous to their survival. As such, they elicited a desirable response in our motivation and reward system. So for example, our ancestors, they enjoyed foods that had a bit of sugar or a bit of fats or salt. Our male ancestors reacted positively to women's good hip-to-waist ratio, while female ancestors reacted positively to males' muscular bodies. Now, however, we are surrounded by such characteristics or stimuli that was artificially modified, becoming supernormal. So we have foods artificially manufactured entirely out of sugar. We've got women with body parts changed by cosmetic surgeries, and men supersized by steroids in large numbers on multiple screens, sometimes in places like Pornhub. We have easy access to psychoactive substances, aka drugs, video games, gambling, social media. We are surrounded by supernormal stimuli. All of these elicit unnaturally strong responses, which our motivation and reward system was not designed to handle. And that derails our brain's neurochemical processes, together with our motivation and our lives. Because of that, you should be extra careful when dealing with supernormal stimuli. Things like psychoactive substances, pornography, gambling, video games, but even things on internet like social media, but also sugary and fatty foods. If you really want long-term happiness, you'll be better off by avoiding most of these supernormal stimuli. Luckily, natural pleasures that were available thousands of years ago are mostly safe, and they are unlikely to trigger this vicious dopamine tolerance downward spiral. Just remember, If you think that pleasure is the ultimate goal, you can still break your motivation system with repeated high dopamine stimulation, even with natural things like sex and even food. Pleasure does not equal happiness, and pleasure is not always good for you. The sooner you understand it, the better off you'll be. And no, it doesn't mean that your life will be miserable. Quite the opposite. If you manage your dopamine well and avoid unproductive excessive spikes, you will have a healthy amount of dopamine receptors. That means that more things in life will bring you joy and satisfaction. You will be progressively expanding number of things that bring you pleasure. Your baseline happiness, motivation and energy will all increase. That was the first of several critical steps that you can take to manage and leverage your dopamine system and live the life you want. To learn about other steps, check out this video here. And if you enjoy this content, you can help make more videos like this with zero effort. Just hit like and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and see you soon in my other video.